So hello and welcome to Nose Knows on YouTube, and welcome to this short tutorial on how to replace your Mini Countryman R60 boot, or if you're in America, trunk badge, the one that they use to open the rear trunk or boot of your car. So as you can see, they do deteriorate these after a while, and you can see that it just gets weathered, and there's no way to obviously sort them unless you're sanding it all back and start playing around and messing about with it like that. Easy enough to replace. I will just give it a quick measure so you can refer it to yours to make sure we're talking about the same one if you are looking at replacing yours. So again, if you're in the States, in the good old USA, you're looking at about 4 inch in diameter, just a bit under. And if you're watching this from Europe or United Kingdom or anywhere else that uses the metric system, we are about 98 millimeters or just short of 10 centimeters. You can measure it from the outside. Obviously, there's a slight taper on it, but you're looking it to be just short of 4 inch. So that's it. If you're looking at replacing your badge on your Mini Countryman R60, then please do carry on watching this video. Okay, so here we have the back of the Countryman. Like I said, this is the R60 and is the boot or the trunk badge. And the model number, if you are replacing a like for like, is 51149811724, and that's the official Mini BMW part number. So there we have the badge itself, and you can see obviously it's a perfect match, but we need to get the old one off. Now, just to give you an idea, that's what the tags look like on the back. Now, there's 8 tags that hold this badge on, and it sort of clips in. They're not really hard to get off. Some are a bit more awkward than others, but you can see there is 8 in total. So 2 at the top, 2 at the bottom, and then 2 on each side like so. So the general idea is to get a screwdriver, flat-headed screwdriver, in between the gap to get the actual badge off. So if I just get a close-up here, and I'll show you what I mean. So you can see the gap there. There is 2 small gaps on either side. So one there, and then one on the opposite side, that we need to get the flat-headed screwdriver in, so you can see it there. So you're going to need a small flat-headed screwdriver and a fin, something to fin and plastic. Now I'm using a sort of a pry tool that's used on cars, but if you've got a credit card or something like that, that should do the job. So the first part is to just get your flat-headed screwdriver into the gap that's purposely there to get it just moving and just create a small gap. So then we can then put, and like I said, I'm going to put a pry tool in just in the bottom here, and then just pop them first ones off, which is pop the ones on the right, and I just need to get the ones on the left just to pop, and then it should just come off in my hand, like so. So like I said, they're not hard to get off. They are a really good design for clicking on and off, so they don't. You don't need to arrive, you don't need to get to the back of the boot, the trunk, or anything like that. Another thing you need to make sure is just make sure you're just gentle, so you don't leave any of the sort of the tags or the clips inside the holes. So if you are just using a screwdriver, maybe put it in to obviously work that one first, maybe go to the opposite side and then give that one a work, so you can create the gap. And then once you've got the gap open, you can then just put it in and then just pry it like so, and then like so in that corner. And it will pop off anyway, I think. It's just handy because I've got pry tools. So the main thing is don't leave any of the tags inside the holes. Make sure all 8 come clear. Then the new one just simply clips on. So again, don't put too much pressure on to clip it on. It should clip in fairly easy. So once you've got the top ones in, then the best thing to do is just tilt the badge sort of into sort of the open mode sort of thing, like so, and then just work your way around the sides to make sure that everything is in firmly, because you don't want to be losing the badge as soon as you've got it fitted. So I've just got it open there and just work your way around the bottom, just making sure it is clipped in. And once you're happy that you've got it sort of clipped in and you've put enough pressure and it's flush to the mount, so I'm just double checking again, making sure that the gap has closed on the bottom. Just needs a little bit more of a click in that corner. And there we go, it's now clicked in and feels all good. So I'll just take the camera off and I'll just give you a close up just to show you what I mean. So you're looking to look exactly the same as when you took the old one off. So you see there, the gap is closed up. There was a slight gap on this left-hand side already, so I'm not too fussed about that, as long as the badge is flush, which as you can see, it is. So there we have it. That's how to replace your manufacturer's Mini Countryman boot or trunk badge, depending where you are, on a R60 model. And like I said, this was a 2014 model. So if the video was helpful, please do hit me with any comments below. Hit the like button and please do subscribe. It helps my small channel grow. And thanks again for watching Nose Knows on YouTube.